Hello, in this video I show you how this app generates HTML and CSS code. But before this, we try add media query to our project. So we click add media query button. Great. You can see added media query above the workspace. And you see is possible set color and name in this and this. But this is show only in this place. You can also change which media you want include in this place. And you can set this only for landscape or portrait, and the most important, you can set min or max width size pixel when CSS property must be applied to browser in this place. Okay, now if we want add in other styles to different media query, we need mark target media query by clicking on media query like this. Now if you have marked media query, you can adding and managing all CSS properties for this media query. So if you want how to add and manage media query, we can move to last and most function of application, and this is generating HTML and CSS code. But before this, I try to change size for selecting tag and selecting to make the query. So I click on this tag and I change size. To, I don't know, 100 pixel. Okay, and we change position for left on 0. Great. We can change height on 100 also pixels. We can also see vertical line near center of screen. This help you to find where is breakpoint for this media query. So now we can unmark this media query. And you can show last function of and most important of application, and this is generating HTML and CSS code. To do this, we need only click on code generator button on mouse bar. Great. And we can see new browser code. Now you can see on the top preview of your project changes, and on the bottom you can see generated code by server backend. You can very easy copy code by clicking on buttons, copy HTML or copy CSS buttons, and he can change generating code on inline styles by clicking on or checking this ready option. And we can see all CSS properties is added to style attribute. And now we can see normal generating code, and we can see media query, font face, keyframes generated. Okay, so that's all for this video. I show you most important functionality, but yet in the next video I show how to fast create table to your project.